There's a chance.
The Rich Eisen shows.
That there could be.
Higher Register. Take of the week.
All right, Christopher, a statement that you need to go higher register to believe.
All right, gentlemen, as you know, I am from the great area of New England. I am a New England sports fan, okay? We got the Celtics. They had a great run, but they ultimately lost in the Eastern Conference Finals in 7 games to the Miami Heat. The Boston Red Sox, boy, that was a forgettable summer of baseball, preceded by trading their franchise cornerstone to the Los Angeles Dodgers, who just won a World Series thanks in part to
said cornerstone
Mookie Betts. New England Patriots, I'm also a fan of them. They are not doing well. They are 2-4.
Uh-oh. What's this going to be? What's the
setup? They are struggling. They are not going to make the playoffs. They are in, dare I say, the Trevor Lawrence hunt. Now, cornerstone, Mookie Betts, boom, he wins the title. Our 20-year cornerstone, Tom Brady, 8-year cornerstone, Rob Gronkowski, they are now in Tampa.
Yes.
They are doing very well. They are a Super Bowl contender. And I'll tell you what, guys, the way my fandom has gone this year, let's just chalk it up. Tom Brady's going to win the Super Bowl. I'm going to be really happy for him.
Oh.
I'm going to be really, really happy for him. And so congratulations, Tom.
Oh. You're not going to be really happy for him, are you?
There's no way.
I'm going to be really, really happy for the guy. Number 7.
By the way, I'm rooting for that day.
Oh.
Oh, my God, am I rooting for that day. All right, TJ, what do you have over there?
Well, guys.
Oh, boy.
To borrow from Chris Brockman, as you know, I am a proud Central and Western Pennsylvania resident who grew up a Dallas Cowboys fan. And despite the fact that our team is one of the greatest of all time in the history of the NFL, lately we have not had a whole lot of success, I think it's fair to say. And I'm going to make this short and sweet because I don't know if I really believe it, but after watching our quarterback go down with a broken, dislocated ankle and thinking that the entire season was over. We had Andy Dalton come in to take over, and then he basically got eviscerated on the football field last week. I got to believe this. Straight out of James Madison. Maybe Ben DiNucci is the answer.
Woo!
Maybe Ben DiNucci can take us to 8-8 and win the division.
Crazier things have happened. Crazier things have not happened.
Maybe
crazy
DiNucci
things have happened. But nothing as crazy as a 7th-round selection out of James Madison. There was a 6th-round selection once who did it, but he was out of the University of Michigan who had just whipped Florida in the Orange Bowl.
You went to Michigan?
Okay. Just, I'm just saying.
Oh. DiNucci. Right,
here we go. I'm going to stick around in that same division.
Oh.
Yesterday we had the head coach of the Philadelphia Eagles on, Doug Peterson. And I understand coach speak when I hear it. I get it. I've been through this and that, and I've heard it all. It is what it is, and we can only control what we control. I don't have a crystal ball, all of it. And you could say that we got some coach speak yesterday, but I did hear some things from Doug Peterson about Carson Wentz. And I did hear about how more and more of the offensive linemen are coming back healthy. Jalen Reagor is going to come back healthy soon. We got Miles Sanders coming back healthy. Put it all together with Travis Fulgham now being somebody that they have discovered in this period of 2-4-1 dreadfulness with injuries all over the place, getting healthy. I will say this is my higher register. Maybe the Philadelphia Eagles are going to win the NFC East with an above 500 record.
Whoa.
Maybe they can all get healthy. They're 3-4-1 after this week.
Wait a minute.
Then the Philadelphia Eagles, after all that, after they're 3-4-1, they're on a bye, they get healthier. And maybe the New York Giants, then make them 4-4-1. Then they're at Cleveland, 5-4-1. Home for Seattle on a Monday night. You never know. Above 500. Maybe they can finish 9-6-1.
You never know.
What happens when they finish 3-5? When they're 3-5-1 on Monday?
Oh, then I'll forget I ever said something like this.
Because that's where they're going.
Oh, you think so? Because Ben DiNucci is the answer.
Varsity
two
game.
Things, two things.
Yes.
True. One of our higher register must be true.
That's true.
Right?
Okay? Because if yours is true, then mine is definitely not going to be.
Factual.
And if mine is true, then we definitely know that Ben DiNucci's not the answer.
One of us is lying to the people. I don't want it to be me.
I'm not lying. Oh, you got a bonus
one? I got a bonus one for you. Okay. Oh, Amari and you were talking about acting, Rich.
Yes.
Super Bowl open, you killed Horatio. It was unbelievable.
Oh, like, yeah, for the Super Bowl open.
For the Super Bowl open for last year.
Yes,
it was amazing.
Right, thank you.
Rich Eisen's actually, he's not a bad actor.
Thank you very much.
I've seen him work.
Yeah, look at that.
Look at that.
Come on, you tell me I didn't channel my inner Caruso.
You crushed it that day, bro.
When you came up to me and Brockman on the boat,
look at me on that boat,
I was like, we got Caruso in front of us.
That was such a fun day,
man. I turned to Brockman, I go, Rich is dead in. You were on.
That was a great day.
You're actually not that bad. Thank you.
Thank you, Mike. Colin Hanks is the evil boat captain. Oh. And, of course, getting the original, the one and only Rex Lynn.
I mean.
To reprise his role.
That was
Those
awesome.
Were great opens,
that,
man.
Yeah, that was
gosh,
that
man.
So good.
That was great.
That was fun.